Last year, we still had more masking in place and social distancing, and so we didn't have the increased risk of transmission in the same way. We're at a good place right now with COVID, but cases are expected to increase during the winter, and this is occurring at the same time that we expect influenza rates to increase, and we're already seeing an early start to the RSV, respiratory syncytial virus season. So with all three of these viruses on the rise, you know, we're worried about an increase in rate of infections with all three of these, and this could result in increased rates of hospitalization too. They're all slightly different. With COVID, of course, we know that people can get fever and respiratory symptoms. Loss of taste and smell is more common with COVID than with other respiratory tract infections. RSV usually results in a lot of runny nose and a lot of sneezing, and generally a more mild infection compared to the other two. And influenza is distinguished by a really rapid onset. So it's the kind of thing where you're feeling fine at 2 o'clock, and at 3 o'clock, all of a sudden you feel like you're hit by a freight train. And then with children, they tend to have more stomach symptoms. So stomach aches, vomiting, and diarrhea with influenza compared to the other two. But if you really want to know what it is, you have to have an actual test, a viral test, to determine the exact cause of the illness. For those diseases for which we have vaccination, to be fully vaccinated, boosted if appropriate, that provides your best protection. And then masks protect against all of these respiratory viral infections. So if people, depending on their risk tolerance, want to decrease their risk of infection, continue to mask when you're indoors around people that are outside your usual household. The standard rectangular surgical masks continue to provide protection. They provide about 50% protection against COVID, 50% decreased risk of COVID. If you want to up your game, you can wear a KN95 or an N95, and in most instances, these will result in better protection, 80% decreased risk of infection with COVID, and continuing protection against respiratory syncytial virus and influenza.